Welcome. I'm glad you're here. This is D.L. Hughes from VelocityToWriting.com, where you learn to write with speed, passion, purpose, and profitability. Have you ever suffered from writer's block? Lots of writers claim they have it. But what if I told you that writer's block is an imaginary affliction? Would you be shocked? Let's discover the facts about writer's block right now. If you're new here, please subscribe to this channel. Also, click the bell icon to get a notification when I release a new video. And if you discover something helpful, please hit the like button. Want to help me and others? Leave a YouTube comment or question, because your input makes a difference. So, what is writer's block? People who say they have it tell us their mind suddenly goes blank when they sit down to write. There were ideas there before, but they all flew away like a flock of scared seagulls when they began to write. Writers don't know how to deal with this, so they tend to wander away from their keyboards. But just having a blank mind isn't dramatic enough for most writers. They seem to need to put on a performance. Oh, I have a horrible disease. I have writer's block. Well, I've been a professional writer for over 3 decades, and I say the concept of writer's block is bunk. Yes, I know there are lots of people in the writing business who love the writer's block myth. Just the other day, I saw an article on an otherwise reputable writing site that claimed to offer over 25 techniques to banish writer's block forever. I had a serious giggle as I read it. The author even had the gall to mention that writers have muses. Listen, your books and articles come from within your brain, and they don't get written by an outside voice, muse, space alien, or any other type of being. That article regurgitated every myth, old wives' tale, fairy story, and lame idea about curing so-called writer's block, and he had to reach back into the inky mists of time to do it. Great fodder for a blog post, I suppose, but there's no real value in such myths when a person can't put words on a page. The myths tend to reinforce bad writing habits. What helps to eradicate so-called writer's block? Let's start with the short definition of writer's block that you find on Google. There's no drama in it. It's just, quote, the condition of being unable to think of what to write or how to proceed with writing, end quote. This is all there is to it, whether it lasts an hour, a year, or longer. People add embellishment for dramatic effect, but that's what it is. You can't think of what to write next, really. Now, if you understand that, you're halfway to an instant cure. Here's the other half of the solution to so-called writer's block. You can stop wasting time with so-called writer's block when you understand the creative process. And here's how that works. Now, I hate to seem like I'm telling you there is no tooth fairy, but creativity is simply brain chemicals and electrical impulses in the form of synaptic flashes making connections in your brain. Your unique formulation of ideas emerges from how these connections are formed in your mind. If you want low-quality synaptic connections and resulting low-quality ideas, then isolate yourself. But if you want high-quality synaptic flashes and great ideas, then you want to empower your brain's electrical system. You do that by feeding your brain. Stimulate it. You gather material. This is your inspiration. It may be your personal experience, general reading, focused research, or most often a combination of them all. That gets your brain waves excited. You process that data in your own mind. This is your creativity machine. That is the creative process. You take existing ideas as inspiration and recycle them through your unique personality, education, and experiences. Only then do you present your thoughts in a fresh way for today's audience. It all happens between your ears. Now, let's look at how to avoid so-called writer's block. But before I proceed with the mechanics of avoiding so-called writer's block, let me tell you that people think they are coming down with writer's block because they are not taking care of their brain or the rest of their body. If you feel sluggish, make sure you're eating right, have fresh air, and are getting some exercise. But let's go deeper. You must feed your brain and organize your thoughts to get words on the page. Here's how you do that. First, you create a preliminary roadmap about what you want to say. That's your big picture. This gives direction and purpose to your writing. Then, next step, do research. This takes many forms. You may simply write down your ideas or memories. You may read books on your topic, or you may interview people. You may do specific research. Now, this applies equally to fiction and nonfiction books. You write down the information so you can refer to it and your sources later if needed. With the collected information, you revise your roadmap. Once your trip plan is as complete as you can get it, you are ready to start writing. Your brain has enough organized information to keep you supplied with words without blocking them. Just let the words flow. If you suddenly find yourself going blank as you write, it generally means that you didn't do enough research or include enough detail in your roadmap. Of course, we writers have a name for this kind of roadmap. It's called an outline in nonfiction. Fiction writers, including screenwriters, generally break down every aspect of their book into scenes. So the outline is just as detailed, but less formal and often more visual. Some people say such planning is horrible because it stifles creativity. That's nonsense. It only stifles writer's block, not creativity. Hey, even though you are following a detailed roadmap, you can still take spontaneous side trips if you wish to do so. Also, if you go dry at one point, you can jump to another point in your outline and keep on writing. You know, there's no need to write a book in chronological or chapter order. Find another place in your outline where you can keep writing. If needed, you can clean up continuity issues in the second draft revision. Yes, I am aware of writers called pantsers who fly by the seats of their pants and have no map and just hope words will pop into their head on demand. But let me tell you, these are usually the drama kings and queens who are always complaining about writer's block. They have a general idea about where their book is going, but not a specific plan, so they often dry up. They are enamored with the romantic idea that they can be spontaneous if they have a plan. But of course, we know that runs counter to what we know about how the brain processes our creative thoughts. Yes, some pantsers succeed, but fewer than you think. I believe their writing could be better if they worked in harmony with the way the human brain works. And it works in a never-ending process of organizing data for future use. You can banish so-called writer's block by taking these steps. First, change your thought patterns. You don't have to be a victim of so-called writer's block. Have a plan to overcome those times when your creativity falters. The cure is twofold. Plan your work in advance, plus always break down larger portions into bite-sized chunks. One of the interesting things I've discovered with myself and with my writing clients is that our heads get so filled with ideas that we have no point of attack or action. Isolating key ideas, writing them down, and thinking about them is how you deal with them without getting blocked. If you feel blocked at one point, jump to another portion of the same manuscript and keep on writing. You can do that when you have a roadmap. With an outline, you don't get blocked. You're able to take a detour and keep on writing. There is joy in writing when the words flow. Try this cure. It will work for you. Have a great writing day. Hey, thanks for watching. I want to invite you to join my free VIP Writers Club. Just click the square. Also, please subscribe to my channel to see my new videos when I post them. And here are more helpful videos selected just for you.